Kathy Vick, Deeply Awake Chaz, 2017. And I'm labeling this one Synchronized Reality. Ooh. So, this morning when I woke up, I had this image of cells, individual cells in a hand. Now imagine, just for fun, it's not accurate, but pretend, for imagination's sake, there are 1,000 cells within a hand. They're big enough, actually, that you can see them if you look closely with your eyes, for this analogy. Okay? 1,000 of them. And I saw, when I was woke up, I saw each of the cells doing their own thing. And at first I saw each of the cells were filled with white light. And the hand was happy and functional and purposeful and helping and all those things. And then I began to see these cells begin to spin with a black. Ugh, this cat keeps getting into paper bags because he's little. He tears around the house. It's so cute and scary. Poor baby. Poor baby Bartok. All right. So they began to spin with a black, and they began to look black and white. Not gray, but black and white. It certainly wasn't a white glowing hand anymore. And I looked, and I could see how inside a cell where that was happening is. And then I began to hear, and they said, okay, now listen, imagine what's going on in each of these cells. Just give it a try. So here's a hand, and there's 1,000 cells. And let's say that in the cells, you look at them, and they're going, you can do it with the fingers too. Hey, I, looking around at other cells, you're scary, you're not like me, go fuck yourselves. This is my space. Go away, leave me alone. You're not like me. You know, called up like this. All right? Now imagine if these cells, if they were, all I do is this work of a cell. It's meaningless. I should die. All right? So if there's one cell in a hand of 1,000 cells, having an experience like that, my guess is that the rest of the happy cells will turn toward the one that's in complete misunderstanding and say, hey, oh, you need some love. But what if the whole hand is got a majority of nothing but angry little cells that are just pissed off at the world and really, really paranoid and really needing to defend them? What's that hand going to do? Probably punch, right? And if most of the cells of the hand are, oh, well, just screw it all. It's pointless. I don't see a point. What would that cell hand be doing if all the cells were like that? Probably just limp and laying there. So, that was very interesting. I thought, okay, well, the way that it applied was, I was just trying to kind of put this together, because I'm not really talking about a nation or anything like that. I'm talking about self, but it applies, because the next thought group that came was that about self. I really think this is the age of esteem. If we really looked at that word, or honor, that has militaristic undertones to it, unfortunately. And respect, that's been tainted by patriarchal violence. Respect. But I know what respect feels like. I know what it feels like to give, too. And I know the reaction I get when I stand in respect for someone who feels like they deserve some and haven't gotten any. We all deserve respect. Respect. But then it comes down to, really, to esteem, doesn't it? So I was thinking of myself maybe as one of those cells. Because I liked the feeling I had when I was in this dream vision thing of being a cell. Understanding, I mean, fundamentally knowing I was part of something bigger. But that how I handled my own little cell really contributed to the whole. And it contributed to what the neighboring cells were doing. And what I found in my daily walk is that, I mean, I would be really honest. Really super honest. What I see being a fundamental problem here, relationally, I'm talking business, I'm talking diseased families, diseased relationships, healthy, functional relationships. The same thing applies, the same idea. It has to do with self-esteem. I came out of years of unspeakable. Difficulty. And then I had that repeated again and again and again. And I see this, it's not a person, it's an invitation. How am I going to hold myself? What am I going to think of myself? Who is in charge of deciding my worth? Who is in charge of setting the tone? For esteem, respect, responsibility, honor. In a home or a business that is run by a respectful, wise, sage, and funny person. It runs better, doesn't it? Kinks, well, they're just a bump in the road. What are we really trying to get accomplished here? Let's not worry too much about that problem. You're okay. A maternal leader. How many of those have you had? How many of those people have been at the helm? Well, you know, in my generation, not a lot. Funny though, a lot of my generation, yeah, some of us drank the Kool-Aid, most of us then decided it wasn't right for us. And we created a generation of children who were brought up in split homes, where kids could see the difference and could see how mom ran the show. I'm not saying all women are nice. Oh my God. And when they go off the rail, whoa, it's like a double insult. It's really sad. It's sad when I see this energy grab hold of a woman. But it happens. I've seen two examples of it in just a few months. They're horribly, horribly abusive because they're horribly hurt and asleep and angry, and they feel justified. And these women, well, they're just mirrors of other snarling, threatening, and dangerous faces I've seen throughout a lifetime of having this sort of archetype shown me. And for most of my life, I thought it had to do with I needed to change me so that I was more pleasing, so they would please just get off of my back for 5 minutes and stop screaming. And maybe, maybe have a little bit of acceptance and good humor. Yeah, right. Oh my. But yeah, that's how I was dialed in. No. No, I figured out that's not how it works at all. It really works by just saying, I don't even recognize this. This isn't mine, this is yours. And no. I won't be enjoying this today, thank you. Now, I've done more. I've worked further with individuals because I'm not a real big believer in just disposing or dismissing individuals. There's sometimes when it's just a lesson, and it's just, and it's not that I don't have time. I've got all the time in the world. How do I want to spend my time? Being yelled at? Being criticized? Having the attempt being made to pin that person's owies on me? No, I think not. It's okay. It's all right. You're going to find another person to play this drama with. It's not going to be me. But you know what? I've been there. I've been that desperate. I've been that accusing. I have been that angry. I've been that terrified. I've been that low in trust and feeling of safety and integrity and validity, where I just need someone to help me feel better, show me they care, show me they care. Yeah, it really feels good. It really, really, really feels good. And it points out how important it is for each of us to show this. Some people need it so bad that if they don't get it, or even if they do get it, they may still interpret it as attack. I was like that. Really, 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 really listened to and cared for and esteemed. The word love was never used, but respect, admiration, and such an attraction. And I just, even in that beautiful cauldron of peace and of healing, I saw me turn mean and petty and scared and angry and small and hysterical. And then I saw someone else do that to me. And it all clicked. I don't like acting that way. I'm ashamed of it to this day. But I have utter compassion for it because That's not normal behavior. That's not functional, obviously. It's indicative. In my case, it was indicative of the situation. And although never appropriate, it was understandable given the situation. In the case it was presented to me, I had not earned any of that. And I got blasted with, like, rage. And it was such an overreaction. It's like, wow. Oh, you're so, ow, 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 ow. I kept having to hold my heart. Oh, God, ow, ow. And it sounded and it looked like anger. But it was just raw pain. And, you know, had there been the relationship established that I had, then there could have been some work done. But given what I just kind of felt I stumbled into, yeah, I won't be sitting down and having a meal of this. No. No. I'm sorry you're in pain, but the answer is no. And it really, those things kind of set things in motion for me. We are not, yesterday, over and over and over again, that same information, that there's been a confusion between creator and creation. The creator has forgotten that the creator is creating. And because of that simple amnesic fact, the creator looks upon the creations and says, my, oh my, they have a lot of power. Well, yes, they are sentient, and they are conscious, and they have free will, but, and everyone's, I didn't birth everybody, and I didn't, you know, it's not, I'm not egocentric. I don't think that you're in front of me because I dreamed you up. It's not that. It's how am I interacting and interrelating with other people in their galaxies? What is it that's being presented to me? What is it I'm noticing? What is it that I'm resonating with? And if I am a cell in a hand, and I'm la la and white, and I really see purpose, even though I may not be able to see what's up ahead, I know I'm part of a whole, and I really feel and I know that my responsibility is to keep my area happy and to just really like this. That's it. Well, that's really cool. How do I get there? What do I do if I am surrounded by people who are in angry mode? Cells all around me in my little quadrant, in my little thumb area. This is the angry area. Oh, super great. What if I'm in the depressed zone? I'm in the third finger and it's just blue. Am I gonna identify too much? Possibly. Possibly. It's a concentration thing, meaning, you know, numerically. But imagine if those cells begin to lighten. Is the depression real? Is the anger real? Is the happiness real? Well, I don't know, but, you know, the effect is physiologic. And I think cumulative. We each have a responsibility to ourselves in our own feeling states. So yeah, you know, this weekend was one of great juxtaposition and challenge and contrast. And then I believe it was Sunday I came to you with this notion that I saw and could feel and I heard this white tone. Didn't dawn on me until after I watched it that I was describing kind of what I went through when I had that major activation in May, when I passed out and, well, didn't, not till the end, but I did, you know, have one of those vagal things, and I had this white thing that was going through my head that was sound, but it was physical. It was like a beam. It was like right, and it went this way and this way and this way, and yeah, that was a big thing. And there's that all the way through, energy running nice and smooth. Hasn't changed. Still there. Yesterday I put on a tape yesterday of the cryon, and I didn't get very far because, you know, one of the very first admonitions is, hey, don't be weird. And I just don't want to ever hear that again from fucking anybody. Because you know what? I can walk down a street and be called weird. And I'm dressed like everyone else, and I'm smiling like everyone else, and they call me weird. And I call myself weird because I'm not like everybody else. So guess what? If you want to call me weird, go right ahead. But I think that's like an insult. It certainly was used by the cryon as an insult. But what I saw and what I'm hearing, oh yeah, that's true. How at ease can I make someone? How disarming can I be? Because what I've seen is that, you know, this energy is kind of like, for some, it feels like a throwdown. Some people get in highly spiritually competitive with me. They like to play takeaway. And some look at me and just, you know, feel shitty about themselves for some reason. God, please don't. Haven't I made it abundantly clear that I have my own issues? So, no pedestals here. It's gross. It has to do with self-esteem. It has to do with self-discovery. Because you just, there's so much inside of you, it's going to blow your mind. And you will have no time for comparing yourself to anyone else. Sure, you'll have to get along with them, but not comparing yourself to them. So to me, self-esteem is a really, really big deal. How I hold myself in my thoughts, and where I don't feel competent, taking a look at that and figuring it out. And maybe even breaking a rule and deeming myself competent, even though the physical end product might actually be the same. So, I'll end by telling you, excuse me, I keep thinking about this. It's been going on for about, I don't know, quite a long time, but much more intensely the last week or so. That I just keep getting this information that wouldn't it be interesting if there was a wouldn't it be interesting if there was a synchronized event for us? It makes perfect sense. It really is about time, isn't it? It just makes sense energetically. There'll be enough to reach a certain tone, and I think we're going to get a ping. I think we're going to get a hit of something. I just keep feeling it. And I don't think that, I mean, obviously, some people are going to be sleeping while other people are awake, but I think everyone will know. And we'll know we're synced up. We're knowing this now. Many of us have had this experience for several years, where we'll be talking to a friend who is more of a spiritual intimate and talking about a vision or a dream or what have you, and they're having the same kind of experience. And this sort of synchronized walking that you can really kind of get floored by if you, you know, then delve back or delve in, you'll find that there is a synchronicity that is of sometimes a very, very large nature. And you're understanding in some, I don't know, body way that the two of you or the group of you are actually doing something together and that you are a unit. And you can call that twin flame. Oh my God, I get so tired of that crap. Twin flames and soulmates and all that stuff. We come in with a huge tribe and basically we're one soul. So, yeah, there's a lot of tribesmen about. And I don't know. In this day and age, I think that I think it has to do with where people are at in their development, both emotionally and spiritually, but emotionally, really. I really think we're all at 100%. It just goes without saying, we're all these sparkly masters in deep forgetfulness. And the only thing that's keeping us from that is our thinking, our beliefs. And these destructive beliefs that, you know, your anger is my responsibility. The origin of your anger is my behavior. Well, you know, boil that down. That's getting pissed off at somebody on the road, dude. All right? Somebody else has got their heads up their wahoos, and they're going at, you know, at too high of a clip, and they're making mistakes, and they cut you off. And what do? Do you take it personally? Or do you go with the flow? And do you actually greet them and say, wow, breathe, baby, breathe? Or do you react with anger? There's lots of people who could tell you that it's very justifiable and safer to respond with aggression and anger in that situation. I would suggest that's that chain reaction of cells in a hand, where one is going, and then everybody else goes, yeah, you don't have to do that. You can see that there's a cell malfunctioning in the hand. That's really not how it's done if we want to work together and cooperate with this hand thing. So it's a very, very interesting little thing, and I like it a lot. Coming down to esteem, self-esteem, and knowing just what you're going to be okay with and what you're not. And I mean, here's how I'm going to close, and I may have used this before, it may be on the cutting room floor, I don't know. But it seems kind of appropriate for today. I went to a very, very interesting talk. And it was about consent and sexual consent and all that kind of stuff. And what I walked away from was realizing that there are going to be people out there who are going to ask me to do stuff, and as the words are coming out of their mouths, they're going to know. That's probably not the best idea in the world. Jesus, I hope she says no. Oh, shit. It'd be kind of cool. But yeah, that's kind of destructive. Yeah, I took that too far. It's up to you/me whether I say, oh yeah, that sounds like a great idea, or whether I say, oh, I don't know if that's the greatest idea. We each are kind of relying on the others to be self-managing, aren't we? I kind of rely on people to like themselves enough that they don't need me. It just makes it much more enjoyable. But gosh, it's really nice being around nice people. And I have kind of an issue with the word nice, but I just mean people are pleasant, who just aren't in your shit. Who, I have just like this night and day thing going on. It's like being treated with respect, wow, it's healing. It's so healing to be welcomed, invited in, pampered even, smiled at. That's just like, and I just, and now it's about me making that choice for myself. Because I've decided, it's my analogy, so I'm going to do what I want with it. In my analogy, these 1,000 cells within a hand, they can move as they see fit. If they prefer to be around other cells like them, then they do that. I really think that's what's happening right now. So really, to end, yeah, I'm always doing that. I got to tell you the unexpected as a result of all of this. The contrasts and the final decisions of, well, yeah, I like this, and no, I don't like that, and yes, I want more of that, and no, you couldn't pay me to have more of that, and well, that's good. Isn't this about, this is the time of no more fence sitting. This is a time of just realizing what your vibrational signature is and then going that way. And having dissonance when I'm around a frequency that is dissonant. It's so simple. And so maybe there's a whole thumb that is just pissed off. Well, I'll tell you what, that's a thumb that's going to either fall off or get diseased or need treatment. We have a term for that in medicine, an angry whatever. Oh, that wound looks angry. Yeah, that's something that's going to probably turn into a fulminant infection. Being angry is the first sign of illness, dear ones. Spoken from a former angry one. Or at least I thought I was. I certainly had enough of them around me to learn how to mimic their behavior. God. But wow, that was it. Mm-hmm. That kind of did the number on my self-esteem. It was the perfect thing. When I just could see it just came really clear. I saw, you know, when there's a detractor or someone who in your midst who is just really not very pleasant, like Trump. And I mean, I had taken from this sort of environment how very worthless I was. And then I looked at it again and realized, well, wait a minute here. That same level of disdain and disrespect, that's applied to so many things. It was applied to my self and my expression, but it was also applied to so many other things. I think that wasn't about me. I don't think any of that ever was about me. And I see how it is to walk into a home where the person who runs that home is kind and sets a tone of what is allowed and what isn't allowed, what feels good and what doesn't feel good. And I can assure you, you do that as well as you walk through your day. Set the tone. So, yeah, I want to be very plain that I think I see this as a time of allegory and lesson and metaphor and story of archetypes that are disintegrating and are flashing before us for review. I'm so grateful for this Trump thing. I didn't, especially after the feelings I was feeling this weekend, I didn't think it was possible. That's, honestly, this is how I wanted to end. I'm shocked and floored at how much gratitude I feel. Talk about the ropes course. And I was texting my sister today, and I said, you know, I think this poison would have just kept going and going and getting brewed and getting brewed, and it's the same poison that's been here the whole time, and it would have gone on longer if we had gone in a way that was much more reasonable with Secretary Clinton, and I realize now that the simple fact that Bernie was there was a miracle, don't you think? That he got that far, doesn't that give you a clue? It's not like writing soupy sales onto the ballot. It was the real deal. And had we been ready, we could have had that. We weren't ready. And we would have missed a hell of a good ride. But wow, talk about shocks and bumps. And I think that there's going to be so much outrage that people are going to have to go within and decide if they have worth. Individually. And people around them are going to be attacked financially and opportunity-wise. Things might get a little, you know, turned down. And I think the question is going to be, is this really what I deserve? Is this really what I think is right for my loved ones, who I love so much, even though I can't love myself? Yeah. So it's the ropes course, and I'm real. Oh, you saw it. I was like, oh, I don't know. It was maybe a month and a half ago. It was right after the election. Oh, God, that day. Oh, in the afternoon, I remember just sort of like taking a minute and just sort of collapsing inside and going, oh, God, the work involved. Oh, my God. We've got so much work to do now. It was just getting light, and now it got dark again. And I am here to tell you that it's an understandable assessment, because the contrast is blinding, and it's so super dark, jet black, and then super light. That's good. I'm looking forward to a synchronized event. I know it's happening. I talked to one of my friends about just this feeling I'm having, and she reported a synchronized meditation that four people were having. It's beautiful. Beautiful. Planetary. Healing. Feminine. This is about the transfer of power from male to a balanced and aligned. And integrated humanity. And I, for one, am grateful and honored to be here. As such, I think it's important that me, in my, as a cell, that I have white light. And in my analogy, cells can move. And I have been in a sea of cells that I am adrift from. And really, I'm thinking, the feeling I get is that actually I'm staying put and the cells around me are changing. Maybe I don't have to move. And one cell just sitting there quivering in happiness. Well, the way our training goes, isn't it right? DNA being magnetic and such. That's a power and a peace that is conferred magnetically, energetically. And can affect those around it. I see this white light as being sort of an emulsifier. It breaks up the anger and it breaks up the sadness and it challenges it. This is a long talk. I did not expect that. It's okay. I think I'm getting to the good stuff. And I alternate between thinking this is madness. And thinking, yeah, well, this has been so wonderful. I wonder what comes next. So I'm wishing you well on your journeys today. Peace.